Hello there, my name is Neil and I am a lion.
Rawr.
In my last video thing, I mentioned to you all that I was going to come out with a couple of Ravenclaw education-y videos.
This is one of those videos.
Did you know
that every natural number can be represented by the summation of a set of different powers of two?
Why do you care? Because cats.
The strong induction proof is pretty cool, and I was going to try to outline it in this video, but it got a little complicated and hard to follow. So let's go with a more intuitive weak induction attempt.
If you have some number,
say 39,
and you know its powers of 2 summation representation, and you add 1 to it,
otherwise known as 2 to the power of 0,
either the original set did not have a 2 to the power of 0, at which point it's still a unique set despite the addition,
or, like 39, you now have 2 2 to the power of 0s in your set.
2 times 2 to the power of 0 is 2 to the power of 1, because multiplying two exponents with the same base is the same as adding the exponents.
But, like 39,
your set might have already had a 2 to the power of 1 in it, so 2 times 2 to the power of 1 is 2 to the power of 2. And you might have already had a 2 to the power of 2 in your set, so 2 times 2 to the power of 2 is 2 to the power of 3, so on and so forth until you produce a power of 2 that is not in your set. Because we know we can represent 1 as 2 to the power of 0, and we know we can add 1 to 1 n number of times to achieve any natural number. We know that this proof works for any natural number.
QED.
Bam! What does this have to do with cats?
Say that you had a small physical object that you could toggle between two states every time you applied a small bit of electricity to it.
It would be like a light switch. If you lined up some number of these light switches, you could conceivably represent any number at all by letting each one be a 0 or 1 coefficient of the power of 2.
So let's apply our proof here.
The current state of the switches is 2 to the power of 3 plus 2 to the power of 4 plus 2 to the power of 5 plus 2 to the power of 6 is 120. So let's add 1. Click. 121. Let's add 1 more. 2 to the power of 0 is make it 2 to the power of 1. Click, click. 122. And add 1. Click. 123. And add 1. Two of these make one of those, and two of those make one of those, just like Karen remainders in addition. Click, click, click. 124. Just keep going. Click. 125. Click, click. 126. Click. 127. And click, 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 click. 128.
Binary. Don't worry, we're really close to cats.
If you had 6.2 million of these little physical objects grouped into sets of 8, you could represent 777,000 different numbers between 0 and 256.
If you grouped these numbers into sets of 3 and you knew that each one represented the amount of red, green, and blue in a single pixel respectively, and you knew the specific height and width of a grid, say 1080 by 1920,
you could display an HD picture of Grumpy Cat.
And it only took 6.2 million binary switches.
In 1947, a handful of Bell Labs physicists invented this little physical object that you could toggle and hold state by applying electricity.
Called it a transistor, and won a freaking Nobel Prize.
So yeah, that's basically how computers work. Binary number system, a few hundred billion little on and off switches, and cats. Lots and lots of freaking cats. There's a little more to it all, like memory referencing, memory allocation, memory manipulation, logic gates.
But these little physical objects holding single bits of memory are the building blocks to the entire
technological revolution.
It's really freaking cool.
So think about how it all works. Ask any questions in the comments and or please tell me what you thought of this video, because I've been thinking about doing videos kind of like this for a really long time. And if you want to see more, or don't want to see more, you should tell me.
Topic suggestions are welcome as well.
Bye, lovely internet people! I will see you next week. Hello friends, my name is Banana Neil, and it is time for another episode of Banana Brain Crack!
Which, if you don't know, is my new video series where I tell you all the bits and bobs of all the